So in this tutorial we are going to learn about record level duplication. By record level duplication, what I mean is that if in any file, or let's say if we find the same record which has already been processed again, then we do not want to process it. Okay, so record level duplication you can perform on the file level, and that can also be performed based on a day. So let's say in one day, if the same record comes again, you don't want to process it and you want to mark it as a duplicate record. So that's where we need a record level duplication identification. So the process is little similar to what we have done for file level duplication. The changes which we need is, one is we do not need this cryptographic hash attribute processor, so we are going to delete this one. Let me delete this one. And so the one which we are going to need in this case is cryptographic hash content, because this time we want to check the uniqueness based on the content of the flow file, not on the attribute of the flow file. In last time we checked on the attribute. Attribute means like the metadata of the flow file, which is the, for example, it can be the file name, it can be any other attribute, but this time it is going to be the content. So that's why we have selected cryptographic hash content. The rest of the thing is going to be the same. More or less, the only thing which we need to do is we need to use a split record processor again, because whenever we want to do record level deduplication, we need to make sure our record is splitted into a single record per flow file. Okay, so I'm going to again enable all these processor which we have disabled in last video. Before that, let me clear the queue. Let me clear this queue as well, and let me clear all the other queues as well. Okay, so we enable update attribute, and we will also enable split record processor. So the way it works is we are going to receive a file, and that file we are going to split based on record by record, and then cryptographic hash content is going to receive that record, and based on that it is going to create a hash value on that record, and that hash value is going to be used by detect duplicate to check whether it is a duplicate or not. So for split record, for the split relationship, I'm going to map it to cryptographic hash content. And for all other endpoints, we can just do a self-termination. So that has already been done. So once cryptographic hash content is processed, we want it to connect to detect duplicate for all the cases of success. And for failure, you can decide if you want to see, you can connect it with failure again. But we don't want to do it. I just want to do a self-termination for failures. Okay, and remember, this detect duplicate uses hash service, so which we have already created in last video, distributed map cache service. So if you have not watched how to create that, please watch the previous video, and then you'll be able to understand this tutorial better. Now let's configure this cryptographic hash content, and in the properties we need to select the hashing algorithm. So I'm just going to select SHA-256. If you remember, this is a little different than previous, you know, hash attribute processor or cryptographic hash attribute processor. In that one we had created a new attribute and given the name of the file name. So in this case we are not going to do that, because the way cryptographic hash attribute works is different, and the way cryptographic hash content works is a different. So let's see in the documentation. So if you follow cryptographic hash content documentation, you will see that in the right attribute, cryptographic hash contribute hash content processor creates a new attribute with the name content underscore followed with the hashing algorithm which is selected by you. So if you have selected SHA-256 hashing algorithm, it is going to create a new attribute with the name content underscore SHA-256 in each of the flow file. And that attribute we are going to use in detect duplicate. So in the detect duplicate, select configure, and here we need to change it to from hash value to content. Okay, since we have selected SHA-256 algorithm, that's why I'm changing it to this one. If you change it to some different algorithm, then you need to change here accordingly. So I'm just going to click on OK. Or rather, let me just make changes here and let me select SHA-512. And since we have selected SHA-512 here in the detect duplicate also, we need to make change and change this to 512. Okay, so that's all we need to do here. And now it should be able to detect duplicate rows or duplicate records. So now to make it easier, what I will do is, we have employee.csv file here, so I will probably take only 5 records, so it is easier for us to understand and see the value. Okay, so I will create a new file with first 5 record and name that new file is, I'll name the new file to employee new.csv. Okay, so in the, let's get back to get file processor and change the file name here as well, because we don't want to read employee.0.csv file, we want to read employee_new.csv file. And directory name is same, I have created this file in the same directory, so I'm not going to make any changes here. And in the split record, we need to have only one record per split. So yeah, I'm just going to change this value to 1. And now the way it is going to work is getFile is going to read employee_new.csv file, and then update attribute is going to update the two attributes, which is input definition and output definition. This is same what we have in video 2nd, where we discussed about schema and reading CSV file and all those stuff. And after that, split records splits all the record which has been read into a flow file, single record per flow file. And that flow file is going to be, in the content of that flow file is going to be encrypted by cryptographic hash content, and that hash value is going to be assigned to a detect duplicate cache entry identifier, and it is going to check whether that record has already been seen or not. If it has been seen, it is going to go to duplicate, and if not, it is going to go to non-duplicate. Now let's run this one by one and see how it works. Okay, so let's see the success queue, and then we should be able to see the content. Okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, we have 4 records in this file. Okay, so update attribute process has been processed successfully. Now I'm going to start split record processor, and now we have this has been splitted into 5 splits. Now let's see what is the content inside this flow file. So if you see, each of the flow file is having a header, and also it is having only one record. So that's what we wanted to see. And also, if you notice, there is a new column which has been appended, which is called country name. This is because in the output definition, if you see the configuration properties, guys, I'm also going to stop this. I don't want to continue processing this, so I have stopped get file processor because we have set it to work every 10 seconds and that's how it was behaving. So now I'm going to click on split record and let's see, the in the view configuration we have selected CSV record set writer, and in the CSV record set writer, if you recall, we have selected output schema, and in the output schema we had defined four column names. That is why in the output of split record we see four column names. But anyways, that's not the problem here. So now what we will do is, let me clean up this queue, because now we see already there are, this same file has been read two times, and if I pass this one, it is already going to start complaining about some records being duplicate. So I'm just going to remove this queue. I'm going to empty the content and then we will run everything again. Okay, so this time I'm going to start get file and then I will immediately stop it so it doesn't run again. Okay, so now we see the file has been processed and it has been split into one record. Let's verify that again. Okay, yes, so each flow file is having only one record. And now let's start cryptographic hash content. Okay, so it has processed and it has generated five flow files. Now let's select on success queue and select in the list queue and see what is the attribute has been updated on each of the flow files. So if we see content underscore SHA 512 has been updated with the hash value, and that hash value is generated based on the content of each flow file. So this hash value is always going to be unique based on the records. So if any duplicate records comes, the hash value is going to be duplicate, and based on that, detect duplicate is going to detect that this record is a duplicate. So what I will do is I will run this again, a detect duplicate, and then let's see what happens. So as we ran this for the first time, all the records which were available in that file is a new record, and it moved to non-duplicate relationship. Now what we will do is, let's process the same file again and let's see what happens. Now if you notice, the same duplicate record has moved to a duplicate relationship. I'm going to stop this get file, and what I will do is I will insert a new record in this file. Okay, let's say I inserted a new record with my name and with country code IN. And if you see in this entire file, so this is only the one record which we have not read, and all the previous record has already been read. So what should happen is only one record should be moving to non-duplicate, and remaining all the records should be moving to duplicate. So guys, just remember the count. In non-duplicate we have 5 items, and in duplicate also we have 5 items. So now let's see, we are expecting one record to be moving to non-duplicate and remaining 4 moving to duplicate. Oh, in fact 5 are going to move to duplicate and 1 is going to move to non-duplicate, because we just inserted one more record in the existing file which were having 5 records. So let's run this, and as you can see, one record moved here and remaining all the records has been moved to duplicate. Let's right click on this one and go to list queue. Okay, this is previous flow file. So guys, flow files are not sorted in sorted order here. So we have to search for the new record which we inserted. Okay, so this is the record which I had inserted, and we can see that that new record has been moved to non-duplicate side here. So this is how you identify or you perform a record level deduplication. So now based on this, you should be able to process duplicate or non-duplicate records based on the use case you have. So thanks, let's